Hi, and welcome to Talking Tech. I'm your host, Alejandro Hoyos, and today we're here in the Cooler Master headquarters in Taipei during Computex 2025. And we're gonna be taking a closer look at some of the different products that they have just announced and launched. And we're gonna start with the air coolers. So actually right here, we have the latest line of air coolers that they just launched. We have the V4 Alpha and the V8As. As you can see, the V is within reference to the car engine. So kind of playing a little game on that, which is pretty neat. I thought it was pretty cool. The one that has already launched is this V4 Alpha that you can actually find. I think you can start finding it already on the retail stores. As you can see, it is actually a six-heatpipe design, which I'll get into that a little bit later on, which includes the 3D HP air technology that just developed. It is a push-pull configuration of a dual fan. So you have your 120 millimeter fans in there. And you have, of course, the blades in there. It is really nice, really well done. I love the colors that they have done, and it's a pretty nice black. Now, this guy over here, which is the V8 Ace, it's still being finalized when it comes to the design. They're listening to the community for feedback on see if they like, you know, the whole play on the V8 engines and so forth and so on. It also has a 3D HP technology just recently developed. And it's also a 120 millimeter fan and then also in a push-pull configuration. All right, so now let's talk about a little bit more about this guy. So this guy is what they just have been developed and what they're calling the 3D HP air cooling. So what it is usually, actually, follow me. So what we actually have in the previous designs when it comes to air coolers is we have these U-shape. So pretty much what we had here, these two. That's how it's the original ones or the previous one were designed. So you have the design here for the copper tubing, and then you have your fins over here, and then this goes on top of the processor. So you have, this is the processor and the heat map of the processor, and you flip it over and you put it there, and this lies on top. So that way you remove the heat, it goes through the pipes, through the fins, and you have your fan blowing through here. Okay, so this is the current configuration of the heat sinks from today. Now, what Cooler Master has done, they actually have developed, they have added one more heat pipe in the middle. And the reason for that is, if you look at the heat map here for the distribution of the processor, inside here, depending on which processor you're using, you're gonna have different cores, which are gonna create more heat. So by implementing this other heat pipe around or nearby this the processors, where the most of the heat comes up out of the cores, they're gonna be able to have a better dissipation of the heat across all the heat pipes. So you can see that it's already removed. The other thing that they actually saw was that having this configuration through the different blades and fins, there was a lot cooler here. So there was a lot more performance that you can actually get in here if you put the pipe right there. So you can conduct heat to these pipes and the fan blowing through there. So you can actually get a better performance. Now, with that in mind, you can say like, well, let's just put a lot of more pipes in there so you can dissipate more heat. But the case is the more pipes you put in there, the more of a structure you're gonna have of the flow. So there's actually a specific number that you wanna have in there. So for the previous one, you usually will have either like four heat pipes, so two and two, depending on how big the configuration or the air cooler was. And now we're moving to a six configuration. So we're gonna have two, two, and two. And this one's in the middle are gonna be a little bit offset. They're actually showing it up there, how they're offset, so they don't impede the flow of air and you can actually have a better cooling. So these guys are the air coolers, the V-series, implementing the 3D HP technology. All right, with that said, let's go check out some power supplies. Okay, so now we're here with Rudy with the power supplies, and there's something that really caught my attention for one of these, which is pretty amazing. And just like my social media accounts, this one has no fans, which is amazing. Rudy, how's it going?
Great, thank you. That was a good punch, yeah.
All right, tell us about this amazing power supply that really caught my attention because there's no fans in it.
Yeah, so over here you see obviously no fans because no top cover installed, but here we can have exactly the same model. It's called X-Silent Edge. It has absolutely no fans installed inside, and we had to resolve a bunch of engineering issues. First of all, we had to create our own platform of the PCB and the whole topology of the power supply unit to lower, to increase the efficiency, lower the electric resistance, noises. We had to create custom-made radiators for each of the hot components inside, and that was not enough because even though this power supply unit is rated as platinum, we had to go even further. We wanted to achieve 1100 watts of power on this power supply unit. Before, wow, it was able to achieve only around 700, but we went all crazy to 1100 thanks to the backplate. So this is a backside of the power supply unit. You can even see the badge here. Mm-hmm. And we have a contact, copper contact plate contacting with MOSFETs from behind of the power supply unit, exactly where we actually place those MOSFETs. Usually they would be on the front. Mm-hmm. We place them on the back as the hottest elements to contact with the copper contact plate and then dissipate the heat through the heat pipes and into the passive radiator. Of course, it will be better to have at least a little bit of airflow with this power supply unit, right, since there's no fans at all. But at the same time, if you power, let's say, 5080 or any other GPUs with this power supply unit, it's gonna carry it easily.
That's pretty cool. So all the power MOSFETs were transferred to the backside of, I guess, the PCB of the motherboard. And you also were telling me earlier that there was a lot of reduction in resistance in order to lower down a little bit more the temperature, right?
Yeah, yeah. That's something we had to redesign the whole PCB to isolate different layers better, so there will be less electromagnetic influence from different layers and different traces, which also creates another issue to, you know, put more components. Every single new component, every single new filter is basically reducing your efficiency of power supply unit, and you want to avoid that. So this was actually designed through 4 or 5 years.
Wow, it took a long time, but you guys have a great product right now. Not only that, but actually once you guys developed this technology, which is pretty amazing, you were able to transfer to other power supplies that actually you're going to be talking about, right?
Yeah, you're absolutely right. So after developing XL and Edge, which is this one, Edge stands for Edge technology, like, you know, mm-hmm. the highest technology. We also developed XL and Max, which is basically absolutely the same power supply unit, but with a fan. And with it, we were able to push the maximum wattage to 1,600. But we went even further, and this is Excellent Mighty. And Mighty, using all the same technology, all the same topology, but with a faster fan, and this one is 2,000 watt unit. But we went even further. This one is 3,000 watt unit. Imagine how many GPUs you can power from that, right?
No.
It's obviously not for the everyday home PC build anymore. It's more like for the pro users.
This is pretty amazing. Not only that, but like you were telling me that the fan only barely turns on if needed, but this is also a 3,000 watt power supply,
yes,
which is pretty, pretty impressive.
I guess you can also use it to train your muscles.
I was
going to
say that.
These
are pretty
hefty, right?
I don't need to go to the gym today. It's a pretty good workout.
Yes.
Let me put it back here before I drop them. This is great. I really love, like, you can tell here, like, from all this stuff that you've done here, it is shaped like a heat sink, so you can flow air through it. Like you said, it will be good to have that in there. And it's a pretty much a power supply sort of built in into a heatsink in order to remove all the heat.
Yeah, we try to integrate heatsinks as maximum as possible into power supply. And since there's many elements inside that actually generate the heat, we had to use some extra high-end components so that we don't have to cool them down.
Right.
But some of the components, like the transformers and everything, like, you have to cool them down. So we had to design a passive radiator for one very specific model of a transformer. Why? Is because we also use thermal interfaces to connect this transformer to the radiator to dissipate all this heat.
Okay, Rudy, thank you so much. This is great, but I heard you also have one more thing that you want to show us, so why don't we just head over there?
Yeah, let's go.
Okay, Rudy, so what do we have here? This is, I think, one of the latest heat sinks that you guys have.
So this is Atmos II, a continuation of our first Atmos, which was quite successful on the market. It has a G9B pump inside, one of the latest generation from us, but with Atmos, we discovered one amazing thing that community like to customize Atmos with 3D prints and all sorts of stuff installed on top. So what we did, we went actually one step further. We're releasing new Atmos, second version, with even more modular approach in terms of customization, how you make it look, and also with the possibility to add some functional modules on top. So for example, right now we see the infinite screen module installed on top. It installed on magnets, so it's easy to remove. This is one of the another modules that will be coming with Atmos 2. But what's most interesting, for example, my favorite one is this one. This is a VRM fan module, so you can even try. There's a fan working and blowing the air into VRM area to cool down, because one of the main disadvantages of using liquid cooling, and probably the only one, is that your VRM area does not get cooled from your liquid cooler. So we decided to create one module that you can purchase from the market with a VRM fan built inside. And as you can see, everything installed easily on magnets with ARGB from behind. Another thing we did is kind of like, a very trendy thing to have with the LCD screen built inside. And again, due to the backlight from behind, from the pump itself, you can see LED coming from the behind. So we try to engineer it in a very smart and efficient way. This one is one of my favorite because it is a quite unique thing. It's a dot display screen. I feel it looks a little bit more old school. Much my style. Plus, as you can see, thanks to our software, you can design whatever you want to display on top of the Atmos 2. Atmos 2 is a part of our campaign that we call Freeform 2.0. Mm-hmm. Freeform 2.0 is an open platform ecosystem. It's when Cooler Master, we are providing modules that you can purchase, you can install on the product. But in case of any module is missing in terms of design or feature, we are actually going to be providing 3D models online available for you to download, modify, and create either 3D printing or metal. Like, it's up to you how you want to do this, you know. But we're giving those 3D models for you to modify and create even functional modules for that.
That is pretty cool, because that's the one way to engage the community, especially the 3D printer community, that there's a big overlap also with the tech enthusiasts. So I think that's awesome, man. You can see a lot of engagement from the tech community on that side.
Yes. Yes.
One question I have for you. So this is a 360 millimeter AIO. Is there, does it come in another sizes or shapes and forms?
Yeah, so Atmos 2 will be coming in two key sizes, which is 240 millimeters with two fans by 120 millimeter. And it will be coming in this version of 360. Regardless which version you want to get, all these fans, as you can see, they're built together in one single block. So it also will simplify the process of PC building for you.
Thank you. I really appreciate that from a PC builder, bottom of my heart. Doing that makes life a lot easier and a lot quicker when building a system.
And we also hide all the cables inside.
Oh, that's really
nice. We build the single connector for all the fans, ARGB, the fan speed, everything in one connector, so you don't have to deal with six different cables from all those fans. Just plug in one and it's done.
That is awesome. Thank you from the DIY department. Thank you so much, man. I appreciate it.
You're welcome.
Rudy, thank you so much for having us here. I had a great time learning about power supplies, AIOs, and also the air heat sinks. Thank you so much.
Thank you for coming.